Hey guys, and welcome to a new series where I'm going to be analyzing historic photographs, and I'm going to be doing it in the way that I just do it normally, so some of it's going to be funny and facetious, and some of it'll be serious about the equipment and, you know, other observations, personal things, because I was doing the series about the reading the stupid comments with the eyes say everything, and I figured this would be a good first photo and very appropriate to analyzing wartime photographs from different time periods. So you can see here, this is just a bunch of German officers, I think the caption said it was in 1916, celebrating the birthday of one of these guys. I think the guy wearing blue, which I'm pretty sure that's like a cavalry thing, or I don't know for sure, to be honest with you, baffles me. He's German though, for sure, with the shoulder boards and such. So these guys are out for a night on the town, and they look like they're having a good time. So we'll just get right into it. First of all, we can't ignore the guy on the bottom, right? Get the guy on the bottom with that, you know, rosy-cheeked, red-nosed monocle in his eye, and he's got an entire carafe of wine. Looks like he's having a great time kneeling down. Uniform is impeccable. We're in a nice double-breasted uniform. And then you see the guy right above him that looks like his younger brother, and he's not in too good a shape, it's looking like. So this guy is staring. Either he's naturally cross-eyed or he's reached that point of the evening. In a wine drunk specifically, these guys are doing it right. They've got wine here. It's not looking like they're drinking too much beer. So these guys have class. And so the middle guy right above from Mr. Monocle on the bottom there, Lieutenant Monocle. That guy is, sadly, I've been in that guy's position a lot more times than I'd like to admit, where he's just kind of, you know, like somebody said in the comments, you know, oh man, we really should have taken that picture last night. Ah, don't worry, nobody will see it. And this guy's sitting here going, what picture? The next day or the day after? He's not gonna remember shit, so he's having a good time. He's like so inebriated that he's trying to smile, but he can't. And then the guy that he's leaning on to our right, his left, the other lieutenant with the Iron Cross second class ribbon, pretty standard drunken German looking. He's a little bit glossy eyed, if you will. Then you've got Creeper sitting there behind him with the full beard, mustache. I don't know what's going on there. It looks like he's wearing a uniform. He just looks like he's having a good time, and, you know, nobody can really hurt him. So we'll move on to the guy to his right, our left, on the very top center, holding a glass of wine. Dapper little mustache we've got there, and I can't exactly see exactly what infantry regiment he's from. But holding the glass, holding it together pretty well. Then you got his friend, another one to the left on the screen. He's got the Iron Cross second class as well. Holding an empty carafe, which means he was either drinking straight out of that, which is unlikely, or he was probably just pouring everybody drinks, including himself, and now he's cheering on the cameraman. As you can see, his little fist is kind of, you know, waving and kind of blurry because it was moving. I'm surprised this picture even turned out, to be honest with you. Drunken photography back then. Good luck. And then, so our guy on the top left here, somebody said he looked like he was the designated driver, and I disagree. I think that this guy is what we would call the covert drunk, which if you've ever had a group of drinking friends, you know the type, you know exactly who this person is. Doesn't mean they're not going to be driving. It just means they're not the designated, you know, sober cab per se. They're just probably the triple D we used to call them, the designated drunk driver. This is the guy that's rocking at about 0.25 blood alcohol content, but nobody can tell. He's sitting there, and the bartender will serve him in any of the 50 states or anywhere in the world because he doesn't appear drunk, even though he's rocking one hell of a buzz. So that's the covert drunk sitting up there, holding it together very well. Also has the Iron Cross second class. So then we move straight down from there to the guy on the right side, or our left, of the guy in blue, who presumably I think is the birthday boy. And he's just sitting there going, yep, not my first rodeo. This is going to be a classic picture. Looks like he's got a... It might just be the angle of the lighter. It looks like he's got a sword fighting scar, which is pretty common with German and just European noble, or not nobles, but upper class men at the time in the early 20th century. It was kind of a thing to, you know, have been nailed in fencing or sword fighting, sword play, and have a big scar to show for it. So I don't know why exactly that was, but it was this kind of badge of honor at that point. And then you've got, you know, Goofy over here on the left, like, he's one of those, he's like the equivalent of the modern day boomer, where somebody's taking their picture and they're looking away from, like, where they think the camera is, but it's really not, it's actually over here, but they're going to look over here at the lens. That's what this guy's doing. Or else he's just looking at somebody behind him, or maybe a girl or something. And he's having a grand old time. And then who we presume is the birthday boy in the middle, that's a class act right there. Look at him. He's holding it together. He's holding up his drunken buddy that's got wine spilled down his sleeve. He's really holding it together with his almost full glass of wine that's probably been topped off regularly by the guy, you know, above him. But hey, he's not missing a beat on this one. Also has the Iron Cross second class. So these guys are just generally having a great time. It's really uncommon that you find a group of Germans that are shit-faced in a picture, but once in a while they pop up. I'm just kidding. So yeah, these guys are, again, let me see if I can zoom in on this and see if I can find the infantry regiment. It's already blurry, right? Looks like 140, infantry 140. Yeah, that's what the top three look like they're wearing on their shoulder boards. I can't tell the other ones. So infantry regiment 140 would be, I don't even know. And they've got the collar tabs on here. And then some of them, yeah, it's weird. Some of them are wearing double-breasted, you know, nice mess dress, basically. And then the guy that's in the shape that I usually was in back in my party days in the middle is wearing just what looks like an M1916 or M1915. Or no, that's a 1910 tunic. I'm sorry. That's a 1910 with the cuffs and everything, the Brandenburg cuffs. So he's just wearing the 1910. And the rest, and the guy to his left or right is also wearing a 1910 tunic. And then the guy behind Mr. Drunky Mick, you know, shit-faced over here, guy right above him is wearing the same. And yeah, so some of these guys have double-breasted tunics on, which is very interesting. So yeah, and you'll note that the guys, yeah, it must be like a dress uniform, like a mess dress equivalent, because they're the ones that have collar tabs on, even though they're lieutenants. The guys that are wearing the 1910 uniforms, the single-breasted, just the straight row of buttons, they don't have collar tabs on their uniform, so that must be their field uniform. So either way, very interesting, kind of unique group of guys that are, you know, in a photo, presumably just, you know, celebrating this guy's birthday, and then they're going to be going back. They're probably on leave or something, or they got a special pass for the weekend. getting shit-faced, it's really not uncommon for soldiers in any time period. If your military allows, or your culture allows drinking, you're going to get shit-faced at some point. It's a coping mechanism. It's a good camaraderie thing. And these guys are having a great time. So, yeah, we see that in the photo. In the background, you can see it looks like either Kaiser Wilhelm or Ludendorff. I think that'd be Wilhelm, though, an older picture. And they're at a bar somewhere. There's no more details as far as that goes, where they're at and all that. I haven't dug any deeper. So this is just how I analyze pictures. I'm looking at smaller details now, but some of these guys are married. Some of them aren't. And they all appear to be fairly young, you know, between 20 and 30 years old, which is pretty typical. At that point, German officers were mostly from the upper class, and there weren't a lot of lower or middle class officers in the German military, in the Prussian military. But so these guys are all going to be kind of, you know, they may know each other from back in the day or something, or maybe familiar with each other. They went to the same school, or their parents know each other from whatever. They're all interconnected. But yes, this must be why they're all coming together. Or they met in the military. There's no way of knowing. So, yeah, that's all I've got for this picture, just kind of briefly analyzing. This is kind of my thought process as I'm looking at a photograph from history, is what I just rambled out to you. I was just literally saying what I was thinking and how I go over pictures. This one's pretty straightforward. It's just a bunch of guys having a fun time. Pretty easy on the equipment and stuff because they're not wearing a lot of stuff. They're just wearing uniforms and not, you know, gear, and you can't really tell what year it is per se because they're all wearing early war uniforms. But this is apparently dated 1916. So I'm sure they had a really, really rough morning and next day. Hopefully they drank some water and walked it off. But knowing Germans, they probably just woke up and went about their business as usual. So that's all I've got for this little analysis, this first analysis. I'm going to do this series probably because it's easy for me to do. I just analyze photographs. You guys get to see cool photographs. This one was brought to us again by that World War I Colorized Photographs group on Facebook, which I've talked about before. You'll find it. All you have to do is type in World War I Colorized and it'll pop up. And the people that colorized this picture did a great job as usual. So with that, we'll wrap the video up. If you like this video, consider thanking my sponsors or becoming one by becoming a Patreon supporter or channel member. $5 a month or more on either platform gets into my Discord server, which is pretty fun. I've got a lot of people on there. And it helps me, you know, A, I like to be crowd and self-funded versus corporate funded. And B, it helps me be able to do content that and I'm going out and shooting stuff, ballistic tests, getting new equipment to show you guys how it works and review it and stuff like that. Guns, ammo, all that stuff costs money, so crowdfunding really helps me be able to do cool content and that I wouldn't be able to do just funding out of pocket. If you can't do that financially, if you can't support the channel financially, that's totally fine. Just make sure you like this video, like YouTube likes, subscribe, comment, and share this video. So hopefully you enjoyed this. Let me know what you think in the comments. I think it's a pretty cool picture, pretty interesting, kind of lighthearted. I did troll a little bit. I was like, oh, those eyes have, you know, what those eyes have seen or whatever. And some other people that probably are from the videos played along. So pretty funny stuff. But yeah, so we'll keep the series going. It's a pretty easy one for me to do. And hopefully it's entertaining. So let me know what you think. And thank you for watching. We'll see you on the next video.